Though to social media, a kind of cut-off culture has been developed. I'm not saying that you didn't have similar cultures in the past. Don't get me wrong. I'm talking about today because we are living today, so we're dealing with what is manifesting today. What I mean with a cut-off culture is, if you don't like what someone posts on Facebook or on Instagram, just unfriend someone or block someone, because then you never have to face that thing anymore. Or if you feel bad about something that's going on in your life and you need an outlet and you have around 100, 150 people in your list, that the one you speak the least to or the one you can miss out of your circle, you just block them. Then you feel good that you did something against how bad you felt. And therapeutically, it will work. It works to cut off, but only in the short run. Now, why am I speaking about this cut-off culture? Because it does work. People do establish so-called firm boundaries, but it's self-counseling. Look, there are people you need to remove yourself from. If they are into wizardry, if there are men who are becoming wizards, then you need to remove yourself from them. If you're a married woman, I'm not talking about social media, just social media here, okay? I'm talking in general. If you're a woman, you're married, and you have old friends of yours that try to sabotage your marriage by trying to contact your husband too often, you cut them off. Or if you have someone around who hangs out with criminals who are thirsty for money, and those people are desperate to take revenge because that individual hang out with owes the money, then you need to remove yourself from such an individual, because if that individual that owes those criminals money often comes near you, those criminals will associate him with you, and they may think that you are deeply involved with him, and they may try to harass you just to get attention of the other. I'm not telling you to walk in fear and to be superstitious and all of that. I'm just saying sometimes you need to remove some people from around you. You need to distance yourself from people. That's true. But not that casual cut off because I don't like something. Come on now. The reason I am talking about this is because this cut off culture has also infiltrated amongst believers. Now look, if you're going to a church, you can go to a church, okay? You can go to a building, to a meeting where there are believers. I'm not telling you to subscribe to the idea of institutionalized church in a sense that you become part of a building that they call a church. No, that not. You are the church. So when you go to a meeting in a building, what we call a church, okay, there's nothing wrong with that in itself. The moment you put faith in that building that you need to go to church, that's wrong. So I'm correcting myself on what I said earlier, that you can go to church. What I mean is you can go to a meeting in a building as a church, okay? And of course, people will have issues here and there. But you're not just going to say, I'm going to leave this congregation just because I hear some of the things I don't like. What? If they are believers and they have the Holy Spirit, I hope they do, then it's very unwise to leave just because, well, some expectation of you was not met, or you didn't feel validated by them. You shouldn't be seeking validation from them in the first place. Now look, why am I making this video? Because this cut-off culture is all centered around offense. It all centers around hurt feelings. It isn't just on social media. It works out in day-to-day contact also. And I'm not saying that it's today that only did we have this cut-off culture, and in the past we didn't. However, we live today. I'm just 25 years old, as I mentioned before, so I haven't lived for 5 decades. So what I'm saying here is that you do evaluate people and all of that, but let the Holy Spirit guide you. Don't just draw people onto you or repel people from you based upon your needs, based upon what you think, what you feel. Use And let me say like this, get used to judge people in righteousness. And also get used that some people just are not going to meet your needs. Because often those needs that you want to be met aren't even yours and aren't even real needs. You have been programmed by your environment to think those needs are real. So you're deceived over there. And if you meet people that do meet those needs, which aren't yours, you are trapped. So look, about this God of culture, you need to unlearn it. I'm not saying to contact all the people you've blocked on Facebook. No, I'm not saying that. What I'm just saying is from now on, evaluate who you draw and who you push away from you. Make sure that you're walking by faith and that it's based on judgment in righteousness, in agreement with Christ, and not upon anything else. Because the moment you operate in self-validation, demons have access to you. And believe me, if they have some access to you, they are going to feel welcome to use that access. And it's not going to be good. So that being said, be at peace.